Okay, folks, so what is the difference between a salesperson and a business owner? Well, the salesperson's constantly thinking about what's the next administrative task on my to-do list that I need to do. You know, what's that, frankly, that job that I could pay somebody minimum wage to do, but instead I'm going to do it myself because salespeople say to themselves, nobody can do it as well as I can. Salespeople say to themselves, you know what, I've been living paycheck to paycheck forever and I live out of fear, so I'm definitely not going to invest in anything for my business, not payroll, nothing else. Salespeople say to themselves, I run my business, but the business really runs them. Salespeople do less sales because they're trying to manage everything on their own, right? This is the sales professional. I like to say that the operator is just a glorified sales professional. The operator is a six-figure salesperson who still thinks like a salesperson. They still try to do everything themselves. Nobody can do it as well as they can, so there's no way they're going to delegate. They live out of fear and phobias with, you know, paycheck to paycheck about money, no investing or reinvesting, right? The operator simply makes six figures because they have a work ethic and they have technical skill. You know, it's interesting. A mentor of mine likes to say technical skill is unrewarded in the business world. Technical skill is unrewarded in the business skills, in the business world. Business skills are rewarded in the business world. So let's segue, let's talk about the business owner. The business owner says, the business doesn't have to be about me. I can get good, smart people around me to do different tasks. My entity does not determine my identity. I just want to grow the value of the thing that I own, the business that I own, right? The business owner says, I only need two tools. This is a la Warren Buffett. The two tools I need are, number one, a dashboard of metrics. In other words, a scoreboard of numbers. In other words, you know, daily and weekly review of pipeline numbers, transaction, you know, that kind of thing. The numbers. I need the scoreboard of optics, if you will. And I need people to change those numbers in the way that I like, preferably not named me. The business owner says, I need numbers and leverage through people, period. The business owner says, I'm going to hire, even though I don't know when I hire if they're going to be good or not. But I'm going to compare their performance to the numbers only and determine whether to keep or replace until I get the people that are capable of doing the numbers or changing the numbers. Lastly, the business owner says, I value leverage above anything else. And leverage simply means small investment, great big return. Small investment of time, great big return. Small investment of money, great big return. There are people that you know, including yourself, that have activities that take time or money, and they don't deliver a lot of results, but you feel stuck doing them. That's not leverage. That's not leverage. I like when people tell me, you know, I've got these people on my payroll and they're not really producing and they take a lot of my time. And all I keep thinking to myself is, what are you doing it for? I have a client who I'm very close with who owns a business entity. I won't get into the details here. And the business entity has been losing money and they're frustrated and struggling and don't really have time to deal with it. And I told him, why don't you just literally jettison that damn business unit? Why don't you shrink it down to size? Why don't you eliminate it entirely? It's a burden. It's return on investment. Small investment, great big return. So you can check out other videos for this one. What are the three greatest returns in business? Well, the internet would mislead you, falsely in my opinion, and tell you that the number one return on investment is marketing, number two is leverage through people. I'm going to tell you I believe it's number one mentoring and coaching, not just because I'm a coach, because I've seen the impact it's had on my life. Number two, leverage through people. And number three, marketing. Hope this video gets your attention.